Millions of people worldwide live with autoimmune diseases like lupus, rheumatoid arthritis, and the disease I live with, Sjogren's disease. And while we have treatments that help manage symptoms, many people continue to struggle with the impact these conditions have on their daily lives. Hi, everyone. My name is Dr. Kara Wada. I'm a quadruple board certified pediatric and adult allergy, immunology, lifestyle medicine physician. Today, we are diving into some incredibly exciting and cutting edge research in the world of autoimmunity that gives me so much hope for our future. What if we could move beyond just managing symptoms? What if we could actually reset the part of the immune system that's causing the problem in the first place? That's the revolutionary idea behind a new investigational therapy I want to talk about today called CLN-978. What is CLN-978? Let's meet the T-cell engager. It's a type of therapy called T-cell engager, and let's break that down. In our immune system, we have different types of cells that all have different jobs. T-cells are like the security guards or soldiers of our immune system, and their job is to find and eliminate harmful cells, like cells infected with a virus. We also have B-cells. B-cells are normally our allies. They create antibodies, which are proteins that help fight off infection and provide our immune system really critical memory. But in many autoimmune diseases, some of these B-cells go rogue. They start producing autoantibodies, and those misguided missiles mistakenly attack our own parts and pieces, our tissues, causing inflammation and damage. A T-cell engager like CLN-978 is a specifically designed molecule that acts like a matchmaker. One end of it grabs onto a T-cell, the other end grabs onto one of those rogue B-cells, and by physically bringing them together, it tells the T-cell, hey, this is a cell we need to eliminate. This allows your body's own immune system to precisely target and remove the B-cells that are driving the autoimmune disease. So how is this different? Reset versus suppression? This is a key difference from many traditional treatments. A lot of current therapies work by broadly suppressing the entire system. Think of it like turning down the volume on different knobs. This can be very effective, but it also can leave us more vulnerable to infections. CLN-978 is designed to be more precise. And by deeply removing the abnormal behaving T cells, the goal is to allow the immune system to reset. A question I often get is, what happens when the B cells are gone? And that is a great question. Since B cells help fight infection, removing them can temporarily lower your ability to fight off new viruses or bacteria. And this is what happens when we use treatments like CD20-based treatments like rituximab. However, this effect is pretty temporary, and generally those B cells will come back over time. That's why patients who are on rituximab may need that medication redosed every 6 months or so. The hope is that by getting rid of rogue B cells, the body can start fresh with a new healthy set of B cells and lead to a lasting immune reset without the return of autoimmune activity. And that's where there's a differentiation between CD20-directed meds, which are less specific, and CLN-978, which is more targeted. You want to think of it as like a factory reset to your phone. It clears out the glitches and bugs so you can rebuild the system to work properly again. So how is a T-cell engager different or similar to CAR-T therapy? You may have heard about another exciting therapy called CAR-T therapy, and they share a similar goal, using T-cells to eliminate B-cells. The key difference is the delivery and the complexity. CAR-T therapy involves removing the patient's own T-cells, genetically modifying them in the lab, and then infusing them back into the patient. It's incredible technology, but it's complex, it's lengthy, and it needs to be ultra-personalized. T-cell engagers like CLN-978 are designed to be off the shelf, meaning that the medication is ready to be used right away. And CLN-978 is given as a simple subcutaneous or under the skin injection, which is far less invasive. So how could CLN-978 help? Let's take a look at each condition specifically. For systemic lupus erythematosus, SLE. If you have lupus, you know it can feel like a multi-system attack affecting the skin, the joints, the kidneys, and the central nervous system, and so much more. A big part of this is driven by B cells producing a wide variety of autoantibodies. And these autoantibodies clump together with proteins to form something called immune complexes. These sticky complexes travel through the bloodstream and they get lodged in delicate tissues, like the kidneys, causing inflammation and perpetuating the damage. The theory behind a treatment like CLN-978 for lupus is that by removing the B cells, you'd remove the source of the autoantibodies. No more factories, making the bad proteins means no more immune complexes, potentially stopping the cycle of inflammation and protecting your organs. Now, moving on to RA, or rheumatoid arthritis. In RA, the primary target is the joints, or more accurately, the cartilage in the joints and those associated tissues. This leads to pain, swelling, stiffness, and long-term can lead to significant joint deformities. We know that B cells play a huge role here. They produce autoantibodies like rheumatoid factor and anti-CCP, but they're even sneakier in RA. B cells also act as antigen-presenting cells, which means they actually show pieces of your own joint tissue to the T cells, essentially telling them, hey, attack this, and they're fueling the fire. So by using a T-cell engager to remove these B cells, you could break the cycle in multiple ways. You stop the production of autoantibodies, you stop the B cells from constantly activating the T-cells, and the hope is you would calm the inflammatory storm inside the joints. For Sjogren's disease, this one's personal for me. Sjogren's is known for having rogue B cells. The rogue B cells are the main character in this disease state. They produce the classic anti-SSA or RO and anti-SSB or LAW antibodies we test for, and about 60 to 70% of patients with Sjogren's disease will have these blood tests positive. When we look at biopsies from salivary glands in a Sjogren's patient, we will see clusters of both B and T cells called lymphocyte or lymphocytic infiltrates. They are right there on the battlefield, causing direct damage and releasing inflammatory signals that then lead to dryness, fatigue, pain, and all the symptoms we feel and experience from head to toe with systemic Sjogren's disease. The potential for a therapy like CLN-978 in Sjogren's is incredibly direct. The goal is to remove the very cells that are infiltrating and destroying the glands, and which in about 10% of patients will go on to mutate further and cause lymphoma, which is one of the real fears that many of us living with Sjogren's have hanging over our heads. This could potentially allow those glands to heal, improve their function, reduce systemic inflammation that makes us feel so exhausted and achy. And the hope would be that perhaps long-term, this may reduce the risk of developing lymphoma that is associated with Sjogren's disease. So hope is on the horizon and clinical trials are underway. As a physician, I believe we truly need to reduce the burden of treatment while delivering precise and effective therapies. I'm hopeful that CLN-978 may offer that. To find out, Cullinan Therapeutics is studying CLN-978 in three separate early-stage clinical trials for these conditions. It's really important to remember that right now, CLN-978 is an investigational therapy. It has not been approved by the FDA. It is not yet available for your doctors to prescribe. And the research is still very early in its time course. But these therapies represent a huge step forward and show a commitment to pushing the boundaries both of science and bringing better, more targeted treatments that are really directed at that root cause that we're all searching for to the entire autoimmune community. It's this kind of innovative research that gives me so much hope for a future. If you want to learn more about CLN-978 clinical trials, you can talk to your healthcare provider or visit clinicaltrials.gov. I'll also put a link with more information in the description below. If you're looking for more personalized care from a physician who is passionate about staying on the cutting edge of immunology, I'd be honored to work with you. You can discover the new patient packages at the Immune Confident Institute to work with me and my team. For daily support and to connect with others who truly get it, check out the resources below for the free Facebook support groups that we run. The links for everything are in the description. But in the meantime, let's talk about the future. What are your thoughts on this new approach to treating autoimmune disease? Does this kind of research give you hope? Let's talk in the comments below. And please don't forget to subscribe so you'll never miss an update on exciting future of immune system health. Until next time, take care.